Catus, Maximus here. Quick review of these Icon 6-inch flush cut pliers. So these are like a bit larger 6-inch versions of more precision electronic cutting pliers. No, I did not buy these. That's the first thing I'm going to say is they want $40 at Harbor Freight for these. And so how did I even end up with these? Going on a hike with my friend. He does some of that wire wrapping art stuff. He bought a pair of these. I saw him sitting on the seat and I said, oh my god, you gotta go to the Home Depot or something and get those DeWalt side cutters, those 8 or 10 inch ones. 10 inch ones are like 25 bucks, so they aren't, I would say, ground like the Icons. I told him they'll do just about everything that you need for a whole lot less money. And so that's kind of the deal. These things are expensive. They're trying to compete with precision electronics pliers, and that's why they have this funny shape. This is for very high access, and then they grind them on the back side. You can see that they grind this way, not, come on, camera. They grind this way rather than this way to get the edge right there flush. And that's kind of the deal. You have something like this. You put them right against it. You cut it, and you can see indeed is pretty darn flush. It's just for 40 bucks, they're asking a lot. It does have a pretty tight hot rivet, so they rivet these hot, and then when the rivet cools down, it shrinks to get them very tight. This is a laser etching Icon, plastic and soft wire only. They do say precision precision heat treated jaws, but no, they don't make any mention of the grade. It's just because these have a really fine, essentially a razor edge, and so they can be easily damaged. If we look through, we can see that there is just a little bit of a seam, so they're not absolutely perfect, but I suppose that they're okay as far as their build quality. They are Taiwanese. And so that's kind of my deal. They do have a thick over or dip molding, but it was like a really thick version. And I have to admit, I do like that. They do seem pretty solid. I guess the one real mistake that they did, and one of the reasons that it kind of annoys me, is you can see that, you know, they're flush cutters, they're flat. But there's a little trick to actually making sure flush cutters get super flush. What I have here is a pair of Lindstroms. And so that's what these are trying to be like, is like these much more expensive, I guess, for their size. Actually, I don't think Lindstroms are that much more expensive, but they are like industry standard, real professional grade. And what you'll notice here, you can see how that the light glimmers as it goes across. Maybe if I show it this way, you can just see, but there's a slight curvature. So that way, the very fine cutting edge ensures that it sits absolutely perfectly flush, where a flat ground like this, if there's something that's maybe pushing up here or here, it won't truly sit flush. And I don't know how much of a difference it'll make, but we'll try doing a couple cuts here with each of the pliers. And we'll keep it to the same side. So this side will be both the Lindstroms, or I mean the Icons, and this will be the Lindstroms. The other advantage of having a curve is the fact that with these, you have to make real sure and real careful that you absolutely don't have them tipped or you won't get a flush cut. Where once again, having a curved surface means that even if you're off by a little bit, you'll still get a pretty darn flush cut. So the Icons are on, let's see if we can't get that focused. Actually, it does turn out pretty good. That's the Icon. Come on now. Lindstrom. I don't even think I cut it that well at the Lindstroms. And if we do it on this side, we can see Icon and Lindstrom. I did a better job there. So that's essentially what they do. I just think that 40 bucks is just a bit pricey for these when they didn't do a hemispherical grind, which is a bit more expensive because the machine either has to be able to rock back and forth or the part does. So it is a more pricey manufacturing process, and see why they did cut it out. And they did include this little clippy thing here, which I guess kind of snaps in like that. I guess it's kind of loose and funky. This is the kind of thing that, you know, you'll end up losing in like no time. So it's kind of a nice gesture, but the problem with the jaw protector is that, you know, it kind of catches on, but it will end up falling off in like the weirdest ways. And I just don't think this jaw protector's all that effective, even though it seems to be working okay right at this moment. It's still just kind of loosey-goosey and funky. So that's my review of Icon's expensive flush cut pliers. They're overall an okay set of pliers, but they really should be $20 to $30 range, more in line with like those nice DeWalt's that Home Depot has or a few other versions of pliers. But if they're going to start selling them for prices that start competing with actual professional grade flush cut and electronics pliers, then they really need to, you know, dot their I's and cross their T's, and they haven't quite done that. Anyway, I really appreciate everybody who's been watching and subscribing. If you haven't subscribed, please do. Till next time, Catus Maximus out.